So that's what you said that just now is a recommendation. But technically, if you want to change the charter, if you want to change more in the charter, I mean, I wouldn't go as far as, let's say, even the form of government. You have already some suspecting. Senator Coco Pimentel believes the end game here is to move it to parliamentary. What you're saying clearly is this has to be done through a constituent assembly or a constitutional convention, not a people's initiative.
That's correct.
All right. Okay. So, Justice, I repeat the question again. It's so clear with you, and you just cited the COMELEC resolution. It baffles the mind. Why don't they know this? I mean, well, it's in black and white.
That's why, Karen, I'm bringing it up, because they cannot get away from this. This is their own rules. If they depart from this, there will be many people who will file a case with the Supreme Court assailing this abuse of grave abuse of discretion. We call mm-hmm. this grave abuse of discretion, yeah, or excess of jurisdiction.
Yeah.
So they have to follow their own rules.
Okay, good point. All right. Thank you so much for the points you've made this morning. I think it expands the discussion on charter change. So we don't have enough time, but I do hope to have you again, Justice. But before we go, I need your reaction on this. Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro says the armed forces will shift to a new concept that will guarantee unimpeded and peaceful exploration of natural resources within the country's exclusive economic zone. Now, we know you've long advocated for exploration of the Reed Bank. What are your thoughts on Secretary Teodoro's statement?
Well, he has not explained how yeah. or what are the steps to be taken, but I am all for it, because if the objective is to get the gas in Reed Bank, then we should do it. There are very few options. We do it with the joint patrol with the U.S. or with other countries. There's no other way, because China will not agree that we own the gas in Reed Bank or in our exclusive economic zone. We already went out of, you know, we, as former Secretary Teddy Loxin said, we are almost all, we will almost fall into the abyss of constitutional unconstitutionality if we proceed further. Mm. Remember, we have that memorandum of understanding. One step further and we will fall into the abyss of unconstitutionality. So we have done everything already. It is time to do something else to get the gas, because that is what is really needed. Without that gas, the economy will suffer tremendously.
All right. Well, on that note, once again, thank you for an enlightening morning, actually. Thank you so much for this. Former Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you to our viewers.